And with the school year starting up, you're going to see a lot more activity in school zones. Ariana Bennett joins us now live from Plum Lane near Wooster High School with a reminder from police. And an important one, huh, Ari?
Yeah, ladies, many people may not realize that the school year is already upon us since it starts so late due to the balanced calendar, but you will want to leave some extra time driving if you pass through school zones like this one starting today.
Biggest thing it means for drivers is slow down and watch out for not only pedestrians, a lot of kids out there crossing the street, but also an increased amount of traffic in and around the school areas.
Now don't forget, the speed limit in school zones is 15 miles an hour, and if you drive near a school, you will want to minimize your distractions, like using your phone while driving, since kids walking to school can be unpredictable. With more than 60,000 students going back to school today, you can expect a lot more traffic on the roads before and after school, and there's a good chance that will add time to your morning commute. So police say to plan ahead, leave earlier, and bring your patience. They say they will be out in force as a reminder to drivers.
At the beginning of the year, we always increase our presence around the schools. We try and get out there as much as we can, as well as the local agencies do as well, just to kind of ease that traffic congestion and remind drivers to slow down.
And just another reminder for you, you really don't want a traffic ticket in school zones. We're talking several hundred dollars in some cases. Covering School Watch Live, Ariana Bennett, Channel 2 News.